Either Cobblepot drugged Montoya himself, or someone else is using his revolutionary rhetoric.
Either way, I need to find him. Let's put our drones in the air and start a search.
I'll run a trace on his cell.
In the meantime, we have to find out what we can do about this drug.
The computer's been analyzing the chemicals from Montoya's bloodstream.
Throw that up on the monitor.
The residue I scan on Montoya is similar to the nerve agent I found at Doc's. Let's see what we got.
It's ironic that Falcone died at the hands of someone drugged with his chemicals. Who'd have guessed that how he'd meet his maker? Prone in his sickbed, surrounded by police who were ordered to protect him.
Falcone had it coming. You cause as much pain as he did, eventually it comes back on you.
We should all be mindful of that. I hope he told you something before he was killed. What did you learn from him?
Practically family, he said.
Family? Funny, I don't recall any Sunday dinners with the mob.
It wasn't Falcone who called the hit.
Yes, well, I suppose that makes sense. Your father, Hill, and Falcone would have balanced each other out.
Computers pinpointed reference points on the two compounds. The men at the docks were doused with the base chemicals.
The reaction was messy. They were out of control.
This refined drug is like a weapon. It only took a small injection to strip Montoya of her moral filters and make her act on her base impulses. Both compounds seem stable, but they're quick to fall apart. Whoever processed it knew what they were doing.
What could the creators of such a drug possibly have in mind? Fighting your wars is one thing, but drugging others to fight them for you?
As far as I know, Montoya is still an isolated case.
Your drones are in position to triangulate Cobblepot's location.
Oh, the Cobblepot Park? Good signals, but whatever.
Yeah, there you go. You'll be alright. Alright.
All the same place. We're just there.
Even wait for Falcone's body to get cold, did you, Oz?
Going to speak with him, Bruce?
Bruce Wayne already tried talking with Cobblepot. It's time he met the Batman.
Oh, no.
Anything ever again. You lot, go check out this office.
Where is he?
I don't know! Please!
You can help me.
Let him go.
Batman! It's about time! You kill a crime boss, you'd expect a word of thanks from Gotham's number one vigilante. Oh, don't worry, I'll pass your gratitude on to those who made it happen.
You used an innocent cop to do your dirty work. I know how you've been using the drugs you stole at the docks. Where are they?
Is this about Falcone? We all saw how you felt about Falcone. Pounded him into a pulp on live TV. If you were truly the defender of this city, you'd have finished the job yourself. Admit it, Falcone deserved to die. Vermin like Falcone, they deserve to be stomped out.
You don't decide who lives and who dies. That's not justice.
But it's bloody well satisfying, isn't it? As a show of good faith, I'm gonna let this one go. How's about we talk this through? We helped you with Falcone. Now, if we could just cut out the rest of the rot, like Wayne and Hill, ordinary folks might be able to breathe.
What is it about this place that attracts criminal scum like you? What does Bruce Wayne have to do with this?
Pretty boy's got himself a fat bank account, thanks to his parents. Only problem is, they took that money from people that couldn't fight back. Here's the thing. I actually admire you, Batman. We both want the same kinds of things. Me and my people, we've got big plans for Gotham.
They found Catwoman.
What do you want with her?
We had a deal. She didn't make good on it. So sorry this didn't work out, mate. I'd stay to watch. I would, but I still got a Catwoman problem to deal with.
Wait, Drax.
Oh, what's her name again?
Selina.
Yes! Oh, beautiful name.
Gonna have to try harder than this.
No effects on the box.
Track down Selina Kyle.
I'll find her right away.
Big fan.